cryptocurrencies, because it's real. Blockchain is not only cryptocurrencies, but we have to use cryptocurrencies as an instrument, because without this step, we can't implement blockchain everywhere. So yes, in 5 years, blockchain will be everywhere, but just if people take this opportunity in healthcare and in the other fields.
Questions? You're not allowed to ask questions before during the discussion, but you're allowed to ask questions now.
Hello, I'm Sam. And what do you think about Apple joining the health records? So they announced 2 weeks ago that they were partnering with 39 different hospitals in the US to put medical records on iPhone and Apple devices. What do you think that will do? Because I think everyone here believes in the value of blockchain in health records. Apple have made a very, you know, public stamp into this movement, and this will not be a blockchain solution.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that this is a fundamental, because my health data are mine, are not of doctors, are mine, okay? And it's important, a key aspect that is access, because as patients, we have to choose to which doctors and to which people to say our data, and also our health data. Because for example, if I am losing my baby, and maybe I don't want that this doctor, because due to personal, for example, personal discussion, and I don't want that this doctor know this about me, I have the right to decide the access of my health data. I think that we have to reflect on this, on in which way to vehicle our data. It's like the story of messengers, as I said before. It's the same thing, like for a pic that we are taking at the bar, for healthcare is the same. I don't want that my data are of everybody. I want to choose to which people vehicle my personal data.
Do you think enough is actually being done? Because I think we in the room, we're all early adopters, we know the impact of owning our health, our health data and the role blockchain has in that. Do you think we are doing enough as organisations who are working in blockchain to educate the general public on this? And do you think there is more that we could be doing, especially within health records at the sort of more political government level?
Yeah, I can do an example. For example, in Italy, 10 years ago, they decided, government has decided to put on digital our health data. Okay, and I am a digital health expert. But the real problem with this, it is that now when we think, we have to think globally, not just our nation, just not our country or our continent. So the problem is infrastructure, obviously, because now we can implement all the projects of the world if we want. But the problem is that if in Italy there is a system that passes through blockchain to have access to my personal data, this system has to be valid also in all the rest of the world. In fact, in Italy we have a lot of problems, because in a certain point of view, health is decentralized, because we have all the regions and it is decentralized in all the interstate systems. But if I am in the south of Italy and I have my personal health data on the blockchain, for example, and I go in the north, the system doesn't work. And if I go in France, if I go in UK, if I have an accident in UK or here in Switzerland, the system doesn't work. So it's important to think globally, to have a global regulation, not a national regulation. This is what we have to think, because in this moment, we are thinking this when we do businesses, okay? When we build a company, we say, okay, I have to think globally. I need of a great communication campaign that works globally. But what about regulation? If we don't have a global regulation, nothing work.
Yeah, this is what's happening with Facebook now.
Yeah.
With a pretty good privacy guidelines coming up. Who's the question?
But this happens also when you think about business and you stop to think about values. Because Facebook, at the beginning, was a really great project, okay? Because the point was values, friendship, for example. But when you are not thinking more about values, like a great entrepreneur and a great leader, and you are thinking about money and about businesses, in that moment start problems, okay? Because a great leader and a great entrepreneur, like I think that Mark Zuckerberg is, has to think in this way all the entire life. He has to think about values, because values bring money. Money is a consequence of the fact that you are working for values and for people, and not only for you. We don't have to talk per se. We don't have to talk for us. We have to think about people.
Two questions here. First is, you kind of mentioned regulation and legacy systems, and just touching on that last question, which I think is really, really important, because I don't think we've actually seen any real live examples of integration, right? That's the real name of the game here when we talk about blockchain, is you're going to have to integrate with legacy systems that are not global, although I love your optimism around a global regulatory environment. I don't see that in the next 10, 15, 20 years in healthcare, just by the way, because demographics are completely different in many different countries. So we're ultimately going to have to look at blockchain in an individual production network in a closed environment in some way. This is, again, my personal view here. But I just want to get your views on, where do you see the integration play with existing legacy systems, especially with the kind of, let's say, IoT and EHR play? That's the first question. And the second question is, you have an ICO going on, or can you maybe just give a quick elevator pitch to the audience here? It sounds interesting.
Okay. As I said before, I don't like to promote my personal ICOs, but I work as freelance. So yes, I love these projects because I believe in projects that bring cryptocurrencies in everyday life. So yes, for example, I work for a project for the rent, as I said before, to someone to rent your room on vacation through blockchain. This is a great example of usage of blockchain. Because
Yobi.
No, it's not B, the name is Yuki. And it has a great business model because other projects don't have this great business model. But the point with this, not only for Yuki and for Hormo Vacation, the point is that without third parties, you can reduce costs. So I don't have a personal ICO. I will launch in next month a personal blockchain-based project in the field of the healthcare. I was so happy because I would like to present today this project, but I can't because we have a problem with the advisory board, because the chairman of the advisory board has a health problem. We are talking about healthcare. But I can say just today, I can say just that it is a project in the neuroscience field, because I was a researcher for 6 years in the neuroscience field. And I can say that it's a collaborative project. So I hope next month to be again here to launch my personal project that is not an ICO. Because we have to think that to implement blockchain, we don't need ever, always, an ICO. Because people are creating often ICOs to do business and to do money. And this is the signal for a scam. These are the scam ICOs. When, for example, an entrepreneur thinks, okay, I want to do an ICO. I want a coin for my company just to do money. Not this the way, okay? And to answer to the other question about regulation, I think that Switzerland is a great example because here we have a very great regulation. And as I said before, many ICOs are coming here in this country to found their society and their ICO. So we have to think in which way, for example, European community has to create a very global regulation, because it is not possible that if I come in Switzerland, I have some laws for blockchain, and if I go in Malta or Gibraltar, I have different rules and different laws. It's good the fact that in some places there is a very open mind and very open regulation, like in Malta, because now people prefer to ICOs in Malta. But it's not this way. We need laws. We need regulation. So I love Switzerland for this, because there are many steps in this way.
So I think we missed. The first question a little bit, but I think you can talk to Katharina after the meetup. Okay.
With a glass of white wine. Beer, only beer.
We're behind schedule.
Can you contact me through LinkedIn?
Yes, I have his contact, so I give you his contact. Okay. So thank you very much. You can come back anytime.
Thank you.
Promote your ICO here.
Not an ICO, a collaborative project ever.
But you're collecting money, aren't you?
No.
Okay,
I
so.
Work for people, really, not for money.
Great. That's
yeah?
a good final sentence. Thank you that you were here. You stay until tomorrow morning. As far as I know, and so we are happy to stay in contact, and we also have two more projects here that might be of interest for you. They are actually applying blockchain already, and I personally think that one of the big advantages of blockchain really is that you already have an infrastructure running. Where you can hook on. I mean, that's the beauty of blockchain. It's already running and you can just piggyback on that running system. Whereas with the national health record, you just have to build the whole infrastructure. And here, everything is already working. And one might think about that, that this is one of the major advantages of blockchain. And you can build applications that keep running basically forever as long as the blockchain is there. So keep that in mind if you talk about possible projects. That the infrastructure is already there.
Okay, I announce officially that I will HIT Foundation in my collaborative project.
Thank you, but I was not talking about that. Anyway, so thank you, Carolina.
Thank you.
So we come to the